Welcome back to the lecture series of Tribology and Nanotechnology. I am Neha Joshi, Assistant Professor in Mechanical Engineering Department at LJ Institute of Engineering and Technology. Let us continue our fifth chapter, that is Elastohydrodynamic and Mixed Lubrication. In previous session, we derived Ortel-Grumman equation for elastohydrodynamic lubrication and also derived numerical method for determining oil film thickness. Now, in today's session, we will cover different topics like what is rolling element bearing and EHL of gear teeth contact, okay? Elastohydrodynamic lubrication of gear. Okay? First of all, we will discuss what is rolling element bearing. Okay? A rolling element bearing, also known as a rolling bearing, is a bearing which carries a load by placing rolling element, like balls or rollers, between two bearing rings called races. Okay? The relative motion of the races cause the rolling element to roll with very little rolling resistance and with little slide. Every rotating machine has some rolling element, as rotation is always easier than the linear motion. This bearing have very good surface finish and subject to elastohydrodynamic lubrication. Okay? In rolling element, bearing friction and wear are very low. Another important and noteworthy point is standardization, which motivates mass production and easy replacement of rolling element bearing. There are generally four components, as you can see here in the diagram, for the rolling element bearing. First one is inner ring. Inner ring is there. And second one is rolling element like balls or rollers. And third one is cage for holding down the rollers, and the outer ring, as we can see here in the diagram. A cage is used to separate the rolling elements. In absence of cage, the rolling elements slide, colliding with each other, and reduce the rolling velocity. So cage is very important. The corners are always rounded to avoid concentration of stress in the corner. Okay? So, two bear the applied load on the bearing are classified in three major categories. First one is radial, then axial, and combined load of radial and axial. The equation of load on rolling element is expressed as W psi is equal to W maximum cos psi raised to n. Here, what is W max? W maximum is the maximum load on rolling element, and psi is the angle from load line, which means load will be maximum at psi 0. As per the figure, the total load Fr, okay, Fr is the total load, can be expressed as using the following equation. Fr, which is equal to total load, which is equal to sigma, psi is equal to minus psi 1, is psi is equal to plus psi 1, W psi cos psi. In the absence of clearance between the inner ring, the rolling element, and the outer ring, psi 1 is equal to 90 degrees. Okay, this means at any time only half of the radial bearing bear the total load. The load capacity will increase with the increase in number of rolling element. If we increase the number of rollers or balls, the load capacity will be increased. The load capacity Fr can be expressed as Fr for ball is equal to Z divided by 4.37 into W maximum. Similarly, Fr for roller, okay, if we are using roller, then it is given by the equation Z by 4.06 into W maximum. Here, Z is the number of rollers or ball. According to the above equation, for a given Fr, load capacity, Fr means load capacity, increase in the number of rolling increments, which decrease the maximum load. The value of maximum load can be utilized to find the minimum film thickness under electrohydrodynamic lubrication mechanism. Okay? So, majority of rolling bearing are lubricated by grease and liquid lubricants. The sealed or seal, okay, we can say sealed or seal, are used to retain the grease with the bearings. The liquid lubricants require some sort of circulating system. Now, to determine the film thickness, numerical method or curve fit method can be used. In case of rolling bearing, there is a possibility of curvature in X as well as in Z direction. Therefore, the effective radius, we can use the following equation. 1 upon R dot X is equal to 1 upon R1 X plus 1 upon R2 X. Okay. So, and 1 upon RZ dot is equal to 1 upon R1 Z plus 1 upon R2 Z. Okay. So, when Rx and Rz are the effective radius in X and Z direction. Based on these two effective radius, a new dimensional ellipticity parameter is defined as Ke, which is the ellipticity parameter, which is equal to R dot Z divided by R dot X raised to 2 upon pi. Now, special attention is needed to find the relative speed u. As per the Hamrock et al. Relative speed, which is given by the equation, u is equal to mod wi minus wo into d square minus d square upon 4de. Now, what is the wi and wo? Wi and wo are the angular velocities of inner and outer ring respectively. The diameter of the rolling element is expressed as d, and the pitch diameter, which is given by the equation dE. Okay. Now, dE is equal to dO plus dF by 2. Non-dimensional film thickness, which is given by the equation H minimum, is equal to HO divided by RX dot, which is equal to 3.63 eta into u divided by e dash into rx raised to 0.63, okay, into alpha e dot 0.49 divided by f divided by e dot rx square raised to 0.073 into 1 minus e raised to minus 0.68 k, where e dash is equal to 2 upon 1 minus mu 1 square upon e 1 plus 1 minus mu 2 square into divided by e 2, which is equal to 2 into e dot. Okay. What is 1 minus mu 1 square by e 1 plus 1 minus mu 2 square by e 2, which is equal to e dot, that we have previously discussed in our previous video. In case of rolling bearing, k is infinite. Okay. So, H minimum is equal to HO upon RX dot, which is equal to 3.63 eta u divided by e days RX raised to 0.63 alpha eta days raised to 0.45 divided by W maximum divided by e dot RX square raised to 0.073. Now, we will discuss about the electro-hydrodynamic lubrication of gear teeth, which are in contact. Now, involute gear pairs are non-conforming contact with pure rolling at the pitch point. However, other than the pitch point, there will be a sliding at each of the contact points. Okay? The sliding motion causes friction at bare gear surface in gear. The friction is not desirable as gears are required to transmit a power. If there is a more friction, then power loss will be there. So, to reduce the friction, lubrication is must. Okay? The torque in the gear pair is transmitted through the EHL contacts. Okay? Now, in order to understand the EHL mechanism at the interface of contacting gear teeth, it is necessary to describe the involute geometry and its kinematics. Okay. Now, here in the figure, the involute tooth of gear and pinion enclosed between the addendum and the base circle. Addendum circle is a circle touching the outermost point of the teeth of a circular gear wheel. Base circle is a circle from which the involute portion of the tooth profile is generated. Now, two points A and B are considered on a spur gear. Involute profile at radius RA and RB from the center O of the base circle. Okay? The tangents from the base circle to the point interest intersect the base circle at point C and D respectively from the triangle AOC and BOD. Now, what is OC? From the diagram, OC is equal to RA into cos phi A, which is equal to RB. And OD is equal to RB cos phi B, which is equal to RB. Now from this equation it can be inferred that the pressure angle at any point on the involute profile can be determined if the distance of that from center is known. It is also indicated from the above equation that at base radius pressure angle is zero. Now gear and pinion in contact at the pitch point A have been shown in this diagram. The contact length is also along A dot into B dot, which is a common tangent to the base circle of the base radius RVP and RVG. Okay, RVP is the base radius for the pinion and RVG is the base radius for the gear. Indicates that contact begins at the A and ends at the B. Due to involute gear profile, local radius of pinion and gear at the contact point changes, and as a consequence, sliding speed vary at the contact points. Now, to understand this, let us consider the figure in pinion. In this figure, pinion and gear tooth interaction has been treated as a contact between cylinders. The radius of the cylinder vary with the rotation of gear pair. We can see in the diagram, pitch circle and base circle of the gear and pinion is in meshing condition. Here in the diagram, RP and RG are the circle pitch circle radius for the pinion and gear respectively, and RBP and RBG are the base circle radius for the pinion and gear respectively, and phi is the pressure angle. Now, let us consider PI is the instantaneous point on the contact between the gear and pinion teeth. This means radius of the cylinder 1 is PI and the radius of cylinder 2 is B into PI. Okay? So RPI is equal to A into PI, which is equal to RP cos phi tan phi into PI. Okay? Similarly, RGI is equal to B into PI. Okay? What is the value of B? Which is equal to RG cos phi tan phi into GI. So we get 1 upon RI is equal to 1 upon RPI plus 1 upon RGI. In addition to the normal load, at this contact point changes, as a result the minimum film thickness get modified to account the unsteady speed and load condition. The minimum lubricant film thickness is given by the equation H minimum divided by RI, which is equal to 1.714 WN upon L E dash RI dot raised to minus 0.128 into eta O V1 plus V2 divided by E dash RI dot raised to whole raised to 0.694 into alpha E dash whole raised to 0.568. Here H minimum is the minimum separation between the gear bearing micro level. RI is the radius of curvature of the interface W. When the WN is the normal load on the gear teeth and L is the phase space. Okay? So E raise is equal to 2 upon 1 minus V1 square divided by E1 plus 1 minus V2 square divided by E2. Okay? So this is what about the EHL for gear teeth in contact. Okay? So thank you all of you for watching this video.